Alright guys, this is Legging Reviewer and welcome to Descent Freespace. It's a sci-fi space combat game from Interplay, well, the publishers of course. And you know what? It's also made by, come on, show it, Volition, yes. I'll show you the introduction, and after that, if you're still not interested, something's fucking wrong with you. Wow. Yeah, for whatever reason it says conflict free space, but it's Descent free space, so I don't know, maybe can someone answer me in the comment section. Anyways, the Great War, which it says here, there's the main campaign, and there's another one called Silent Threat. So, what's going on in this plot here, in this game? So, here's the thing for the plot. Some kind of unknown alien is attacking everyone. Even your arch-nemesis, the Vizudans, because you're a Terran. And because of that, they just want to destroy the whole thing, you know, the whole universe. Now, you gotta admit, that was a pretty intense cutscene. That was a pretty intense introduction. I love the voice acting in this one. I just love it, the way it was made. Like, good mystery kind of vibe to it, which means you don't know what's going on, which is kind of cool for me. There's this awesome voice acting. It is good. There's these capital ships, and yes, in this one, capital ships are even better than other games of its time, because this one was released in 1998. If you remember, there's the X-Wings games, the TIE Fighter games, Freelancer, Wing Commander, and many other more that I just can't remember right now, but there's a lot. This game just makes it better. It didn't reinvent anything. It didn't create anything. It just made it better. This is your ship, of course, but there's other ships, as in the Valkyrie, and, well, there's a lot of others here. You got the mission simulator if you want to do the other missions as well. And the story follows in the cutscenes, the briefing, the debriefing, and sometimes the news that's going to appear in the game. This game is for a, I would say, like in my series, cheap games for cheap computers. This one, man, it's so low. 1.4 gigahertz and 512 megabytes of RAM. So if you got a computer that's 2-core that you bought a couple of years ago, but you think it's old, this will run it perfectly. And for the graphic card, even the integrated graphic card will be okay. In the settings, I don't know why, but it's going to be laggy, but it supports joysticks. You can go with, oh yeah, my skill level was insane, okay. I tried to record earlier, but for whatever reason, the screen was very small, so I had to go back to easy. I'm gonna do it with easy. If you want to do it with insane like I just did last mission, I did succeed, but yeah, it was insane. I died like 3-4 times or whatever, and I wondered, what the hell's wrong? That explains it. Yeah, you got a lot of controls, but usually, next ship, the closest hostile ship, and nearest attacker, especially nearest attacker, is the, like, that's what you need to remember. You got your ship controls, which has a lot, of course. The afterburner is very important, the tab key. You got your weapons. You also got your, oh, this is very, really important. You press C, then you can give orders to your wingman. You have wingmen, use them. Very important. Don't let them rot on the side. You will probably die anyway if you do that. You can disarm, you can disable, you can attack. There's multiple, well, you got more, of course, but there's multiple types of missions in this one. You got, and you also got multiple types of objectives. Sometimes you got to disable a ship, sometimes you got to destroy it, rescue a ship, protect it, man, so on and so on. Like I said, there's the main campaign and there's the silent thread. It's a bit of a DLC if you ask. So let's go on the screen here, the mission screen. That's another, yeah, let's skip this. I'm just gonna skip it. I'm not gonna let it show to you.
Command has decided that the GTSC Plato will carry the prototype for the Avenger attack cannon through the Antares system.
Oh, so yeah, we got another one here. So you got a ship selection right now. There's not much available, but over the time of the game, you will have some available. They have their pros, their cons, their strength, and their weakness. So it's really important that you know them. But it's gonna be pretty straightforward. Same thing for the weapons. Some are not better, but like, you got this regular weapon, you got the disruptor as well. That allows you to disable your like the other ships. I don't do that. I just use my cannon to disable subsystems. Yeah, by the way, for example, if you want to disable the weapon subsystems of your enemies, which prevents them from shooting you, you just have to press the S key until the weapon subsystems appear, and you just shoot. Same thing with the missiles you got. This is the big boom, this is the small boom. So let's go ahead with the mission here. Let me show you what it is. Escort Plato. Yeah, this is going to be a boring mission, I guess. So I can... Oh, yeah, by the way, while I do this, if you look at the lower right part of the screen, there's going to be like the G and E with some levels on it or some gauge or something. In old games like, in other games like TIE Fighter and Xwings and all, you had to manage the power of your ship. Like, give more energy to the weapons, give more energy to, I don't know, the engines or so. So let's do that. But they weren't really... So you had to manage it carefully, and you really had to do it all the time. With this game, it's less it's more forgiving. Yeah, from insane to easy, it's a bit more forgiving as well. Alright, should be able. Press G again. Whoops. Osiris, who's that again? Anubis. Isn't that a god or something? Can't remember. Yeah, you gotta use your mouse carefully. If you do have a joystick, now would be the time to use it. Just to... I would say, let's match the speed here. Oh, yeah, this, all fighters, and destroy my targets. You know what? C3N9, engage the enemy. Never let them rot on the side.
Enemy wing has just arrived.
Alright, there's another one here. Yeah, you got your radar as well, so. Nearest attacker. Oops, you got your. If you look at the HUD here, whoop, let me go on the Anubis here. If you look on the HUD, on the bottom part. You have the lead indicator, which tells you where to shoot. You also have your radar, which is really useful. Let's press M to match the target again. Oops. Wow, 8,000. I'll let them work there, because they look to be... They look far away, what the hell? Yeah, where is he? Yeah, he's there, like, he's very far away for whatever reason. Like, they're really far away, what the fuck? It's like 7,000 or something. PVC Athen. Nah. I don't know what's going on here. God damn it. Alright, those are the aliens. I gotta take a look at it. Just gotta know where are they. Alright, let's find out. Alright, my afterburner is done. It's getting a recharge. Oh yeah, there they are. I can see them on the radar. They're going cuckoo here. My radar is going nuts. As you can see, the red going... It flips. Let's go on Osiris. Let's speed up a little bit here. The unknowns are jumping out. Did anyone get a close look at one? I was too far away. What the fuck? Hey, let me destroy him here. More unknowns appearing. They're going for the Plato. Nah, it's really far away. What the hell? Oh man. Am I gonna succeed or something? Yeah, let me speed up here as fast as I can. Oh my god, I'm not gonna succeed. Maybe, okay. I'm not really sure. Let me take a look at those enemies. Come on. 25. Yeah. Oh yeah, here they are. Let's take a look at them. To know who the fuck we're dealing with. Good. Let's try to shoot them. Nope. Can't do shit. Fuck you want me to do? Whoa. Where are they? No. No, don't get away. God damn it. Wait, there's another one here. Where is it? Okay, he's right up here. Manually match the target. Ah, shit. That hurts a lot. For the escape pod. Where is it? I just gotta keep him busy, I guess. Those are the aliens! The advanced ones. Whoa, what the fuck? My god. No! Ah, shit! I shot you. My god. Can't do shit against this one. So, do I have to cancel the mission, or just that's it? Oops. That was a bad move for me. Alright, let's get away here. Can I go away? Max throttle, no, okay, yeah, let's get away here. Subspace drive engage. Yeah, there's no orders right now, so I can't get away. So you gotta pay attention to the chat, to the visuals on your screen.
From your ship's sensors records, it appears there was little you could have done to protect the Plato. Its loss will be mourned, but at least her crew is safe.
Yep.
Intelligence has analyzed the data you provided from the attempted visual identification. There is no record of such ships. They do not appear to be Vasudan. The conclusion is that they belong to a new species. These ships are not detectable by our sensors. Worse, they appear to have some type of energy shielding system, making them nearly immune to our attacks. But the greatest concern is their weapons. They are more powerful than anything in the GTA or VPE arsenal. We believe the data you gathered will prove valuable in discovering a weakness in this new adversary. In all of their recent attacks in Terran space, not one of these unknown fighters has been destroyed. It is hoped that a weakness will be found soon.
No. Recommendations. What can I do? Does it tell? No. That's weird. Oh, yeah. There it is. If you can destroy one of the unknown fighters, it can prove to the GTA that their fighters are not invulnerable. That would certainly boost morale all over the GTA. Which means I could replay the mission and succeed until one dies, at least. We'll accept that. There's another mission and so on and so on. So that's the thing. That's the
new species. Till further contact is established, command has designated them Shivans. The Shivans have inflicted heavy casualties to both Terran and Vasudan forces in the Beta Cygni and Vega systems, and appear to be making a rapid push into other key systems along the Terran Vasudan front. All contact has been lost with our forces.
So yeah, that's the game in a nutshell. If you do like space fighting games and you can't wait until Star Citizen or Elite Dangerous, or if you don't have it, or you don't have the money, for $6 on GOG or so, or Steam, you can't go wrong with this game. It's just like impossible. Anyways, I'm out. I hope you liked the video, and if you didn't like it, just tell me why. What I can improve in this video, well, other videos as well. So we'll see you later. Bye-bye.